Hello everybody, and welcome to some Age of Wonders. Let's have a look at the... So this is my new game that I've started playing. Let's just start a new campaign. Go from there. So, yeah, let's get into it.
The Wheel of Ages turns, set in motion by two opposing powers preparing for war. The Commonwealth, humanity's greatest empire, spreads to every continent. Emperor Leonis promises to reward ambition regardless of race, creed, or descent. The empire's machines roll forward, bringing wealth to those willing to crush all opposition. The Elven Court will not submit. It is our duty to protect Athla, so that the wonders of our world will never fade. My name is Sundren, and this is my journal. My father is King Saradas, once first Stormlord of the Dark Elves. My mother is Julia, former Queen of the Wood Elves. Their passion reunited dark and light souls, restoring the High Elves. Their power reinvigorated the glory of Inioch's ancient Elven Court. My brother, Prince Thanis, is firstborn. He is schooled in war and statecraft, destined to great deeds. I was born second, and a girl. All my father wants me to do is secure a powerful husband, but I want none of that. In public, I may be a dutiful daughter, but I have trained and I have spied. I will be more than just a princess. In the court, envoys come and go. Everyone talks of war. Many flock to the banner of our elven court, seeking refuge from the human-run Commonwealth with their technologies of metal and smoke.
Warlock, one of the advisors to your father, approaches you with an offer. I have noticed your interest in matters of state, Sundren. It is wise of you to learn to train for possible conflict. The humans are growing ever bolder, and if we should come to war, the Elven Court will be stronger for your efforts. If you want to learn more, I can tutor you. Welcome to Alador. The legendary Isles is the provincial is pivotal in the history of elves, but pox-ridden vermin known as goblins are freely defiling its beauty with their blighted diseases, even ransacking the tomb of your grandmother Elwyn. You shall have to cleanse this land of their insolent presence. I have given you the Tome of Wonders, a book describing our world in detail. Sometimes I will refer to it. You can click the blue words to gain extra information from the tome. Come on. Let's start with building a stone house in your village. Storehouse in your village. It will help village grow to a town faster, expanding your domain and giving you more income and production capacity, which you will need for training new armies. Left click on your city to open your city interface. Welcome to your city. Selecting a city option opens the city overview. The city overview gives you information on the city's current population, size and income. Resources produced in cities are added to your global resource pool. City resources. Gold is used to build city upgrades and units. Mana is used to cast spells, and knowledge is used to research new skills. Production indicates how fast a city can build city upgrades and units. Population growth determines the time it takes for a city to grow. City production. The tabs to the left of the screen show the units and upgrades the city can produce, while the queue of things the city is producing is displayed in the center of the screen. The total cost of a unit to upgrade divided by the hammer of a city determines the number of turns it takes to for it to be built. Yeah. Since you already start with a large army, you should concentrate on upgrading your city. Building a storehouse in this city will increase the city's population growth by 100, allowing the city to grow and expand its borders faster. To build a storehouse, select produce upgrades from the tabs on the left. Select the storehouse. Okay. Best for my face and the chat. Like on the side looks good. Right, explore the island. Belongs to the Elven Court. Goblins are desecrating its pristine nature, despoiling the tomb of Helen, once queen of all elves. We should explore the island and see what the tomb ourselves. To do this, we can capture watchtowers or send units to scout. Okay. Right, researching skills. This is your skill book. The current page shows the skills you can research, which include new spells, upgrades to your empire, and new units can produce. Knowledge is used to fuel research. It is produced in your cities from laboratories and observatories, as well as far from certain structures in your domain, such as vaults of knowledge. Start researching basic seafaring since you are on an island. Okay. You have selected an army. Okay. An army is a stack one up to six units on a single hex, and it is used to explore the world, attack your enemies, and defend your cities. When an army is selected, you can click on the units icon to get more information about them. After selecting an army, you can order it to move by right-clicking the hexagon you want it to move to. A preview will highlight the route to be taken with the selection in green, section in green, showing how far your army is able to move this turn. More move Sandrine's army to the gold mine to the northeast by right clicking on it.
Okay. That one.
That's the gold mine, okay. Sandrine, it's good to see you. We are on our way to welcome you in the city, only to see these goblins have taken over the gold mine. There are too many for us. If we attack with both our armies, we can overwhelm them with superior numbers.
Sure.
One moment, Sandrine. More armies are always good, but armies need to be paid upkeep. These soldiers have joined us, and gold income will be lower.
Okay. Alright, let's see what the combat's like.
And is my face in the way at all? Is the chat alright? It's time for us to begin our attack on the enemy. The defenders always get to act first. We should use this moment to examine our opponents and think up a strategy.
Okay.
Now it is time for us to act. We can select individual units, give them orders. Once all our units have moved, we can end our turn. Each unit has action points, which are used up by moving and attacking.
Okay.
During combat. Goblin untouchable. High elf swordsmen. Swordsmen are infantry units. Swordsmen have swords and shields and ideal for protecting your longbowmen and storm sisters.
Okay.
I have Storm Sister. Storm Sister sisters are support units. They have a powerful ranged attack that does shock damage, making them very effective against machines. They also have a stun touch ability, letting them paralyze dangerous enemies before they can do too much damage. Sunderin. Is your leader. Leaders are one of the strongest units in your army and are able to cast spells in battle instead of attacking. They can even cast spells when they are not personally present on the battlefield, though this is more expensive to do so. During your journey, you will also encounter heroes who have their own special abilities to use in battle.
Nice.
First victory. Okay, the mine. Nice. Got some more money. Nice. The squads like that are pretty good, actually.
There, our enemy. When will they ever learn to live in harmony with what they have, instead of greedily wanting more? I guess their short lives make it impossible for them to see the consequences of their actions. They do not need to sustain their surroundings. That is why you need to take responsibility. Your family has long ruled the world. And should do so again.
Nice. Nice water there, nice. Elves of Alador, you have asked us for help with this goblin infestation.
They should be honoured that one of Leoc's heirs graces them with a visit. Independent towns will offer friendship and quests, but some may be hostile. Let us see what they have to say. Yeah, I'm enjoying it. It's good. It's good. How you doing, Petro? You alright? Have you played this before? I'm playing it because I saw the announcements come up and I'm like, ooh, they look good. Announcement for 4. So I'm like, yeah, get this one.
New army. Okay. Pikemen. And longbowmen. That's seafaring. Oh, so I need to build that to build the better things.
Okay.
More population, big growth.
Summon the bird? Yeah, let's do that.
Picked up big research bonus.
Sweet.
Players when they were ready, but I played solo. I finished campaigning. Oh, nice. Nice, nice, nice. Well, I'm always up for finding people to game with. If you're up for doing a multiplayer on stream, we can do that. I'm totally up for playing this game more. Obviously, I've just started playing, so I'll be a fairly new player. But I play strategy games, so yeah. If you're up for that. Have you played it long? It's given me like Heroes of Might and Magic vibes. Obviously Civilization vibes as well. Refugee camp. The people in these camps will provide population. They have hidden themselves far away from the surrounding mountains. You use your crow to rescue them. Since Grimbeak crows are flying units, they do not have to spend as much extra movement to move over mountains as walking units do.
Cool.
Dangerous to move like this on the river, really? That's funny. I mean, hey, I'm always up for getting attacked by krakens. Why not? Why not? Level up governance, okay. So we can give shooting, longbowmen and hunters plus range. I mean, that sounds good. Or more growth. I'm thinking ranged combat sounds good. We've got archers on the go. And this is upgrading archer units, additional rank in the city. I mean, that sounds good. Let's do that as well. So wait 2 turns, then start recruiting some archers. Sounds good. Okay, so I can use a spell to summon one of those. Alright, that sounds cool. Land cleansing. Well, with goblins about, we probably want to learn that one. Okay, so cast a spell. Alright. This page lists the global spells. Global spells that can be cast on the strategic map. They require mana and casting points to cast. Okay, casting points 20. Okay. You can cancel it. Okay. Alright, so let's. We can get some crows or we can get a bigger bird. Let's get the bigger bird. Takes 2 turns to summon. Alright. Right, in the meantime, we've got bandits to stomp out. Yep. Okay. Whole bunch of bandits. Thank you.
Scoundrels.
Orcs and scoundrels, okay.
Let's have a look.
Made of.
See what these are made of.
Destroying obstacles. These bandits have built themselves defensive pillars around their camp. While not sturdy as city walls, they provide cover and need to be destroyed before you can enter the camp. Obstacles can be destroyed with melee attack of any unit. Okay. Alright. I have longbowmen. Archers possess powerful ranged attacks, but need to be protected from melee attacks since they cannot shoot when engaged, meaning they are stood in the threatened zone or adjacent enemy. The range of their attacks is usually the distance a normal unit can move in one turn. If you can shoot them, kill them, or block their path with another unit to avoid getting struck the turn after. Makes sense. Okay, so what else we got? Union guards. Elf Union Guard. Pikemen do extra damage against cavalry and flying units, take less damage in return, however they tend to be weaker against ranged and infantry. They have the first strike ability. Okay. Longbowmen. Initiates are the type of irregular unit. Irregulars are divided into like units, often fulfill multiple roles in the army since they usually have both melee and ranged attacks. Okay, sweet. Unicorn Riders. The cavalry have a high movement speed and are effective against archers since they can charge from outside the archer's attack range into melee in one round. Unicorn riders can phase, allowing them to teleport across the battlefield. That is pretty cool. Thank you. When your leader is defeated in battle, but still has their throne city, they will escape into the void. While your leader is in the void, research is halted and cannot cast spells which you, your leader, with your leader. Your leader will return to the throne city after 3 turns. To know. Hi, Elf Sattler. Thank you for making the safe area safe. We wanted to found a new settlement here, but the brigand hideout made it too dangerous. Please allow us to join you. This provides an excellent opportunity to found a new city. Settlers can be used to build cities from scratch, to rebuild a raid city, or to create a new city on a loop. On the location of a fort. When you found a city on existing fort, the fort wall will remain protecting the new outpost. Thank you. constructs an outpost or rebuilds a city. Alright. Shortcut to Echo's domain. Cave on underground.
Okay, cool.
Cave and underground. Cool. Well, I think we'll leave it there for now. We'll save there. Okay. Saved. And I'll exit back out to the main menu. And I want to thank everyone for stopping by. And this is the fun new game. you, everybody, and we'll see you next time. Let's see if we can find someone to raid. No one online, so we'll just call it that. Alright, thanks everybody. See you next time.